All right, we've had some questions about the combo mat. Combo mats where we got the micro, KP, and the mini. This is the original dream mat. Okay, a lot of people have asked, and not just one person piped up on the dream mat page, but I get a lot of email requests for this. They say, you know, people pipe in and say, Dave, shouldn't this be up here and this down here? And I'm, I'm like, oh, okay. And I'm going to go through a little story to kind of help land the plane, bear with me, to understanding why we do it this way. All right, here's the original dream mat. Okay, the original dream mat's 3 foot long. So the original dream mat, it gets sent to Australia to Dustin McMurray, Gold Rat High Bankers. He is currently using the tape together duct tape mat. But he has a high banker, kind of like you would have like the Raptor flares and stuff like that, you know, the bankers that go into. Where you got a smaller box and it flares out to a bigger box. You got 3 foot up here, 3 foot down there, 6 foot of banker. All right. So anyways, he's going to come out with his new product line, going to make it happen, all this other stuff. He takes one of these, throws it in the upper box, and then he says, you know, Dave, recovery's so good on this, I don't even need the lower box. I'm getting rid of it. Don't need the flare. I can do everything I need to do in the first 3 foot and just offer 8-inch, 10-inch, and 12-inch. Better product value for the customer, easier to pack around, better recovery. Let's do it. That's where our partnership began. All right, so here's a guy that was there, had been using that mat for a long time, all the different combinations, different lengths, very knowledgeable in it. And even selling it at one time. All right, over there. All right, so enough of that. So here's a mat that's recovery can happen in a shorter amount of time. Eliminate migration. Now let's all go back into Dream Mat 101 and understand that when the material comes in, it goes up and captures. Up and captures, it doesn't roll out. We eliminate migration, so anytime something has a chance of coming out, it has to go back and up before it comes out. Back and up, so we pull migration, we break the back of migration, we bring it to the top. All right, so what I'm trying to get at here is that we have this name out there a lot of people hit, and they call it front row gold, meaning that we seem to be catching our gold all in the front rows, and back here doesn't really seem to be happening much. We seem to be having our recovery mostly up there. Now, of course, if we had a boomer clean up and we had 200 ounces of gold, we're going to see gold come down the mat because that's just the way it is. But on normal days, normal recovery, we're not getting 200 ounces of gold. We're getting grams of gold. We're catching it up in the front. That's where the recovery's happening. The other mats, because they don't bring the gold in and up, they roll it out, they migrate gold down the mat. So what they have to do to compete with this newer technology, this alien tech, this so new that there's nothing like it, we have to put the most aggressive pattern up front in hopes that we catch everything there, because we can't let it roll out. Because once it gets rolling, it builds momentum, builds inertia, and rolls on out. Now, and we don't want the least aggressive mats of their choosing up front, because we'd have more inertia happening. But if you look at what's going on, when the material comes into the sluice box, as it moves through the box, it gets more churned. Here, it has been churned less than here. Our churning, the most churning the material is going to happen, or agitation, or exchange, or chances of gold liberating and falling out. I'm going to say this again because I don't want you guys to miss it. Let's go back to it again. And this is a big point. The most agitation, the most exchange, the most of everything that's going to happen to that gold, give chance to fall out, is going to happen here. It's not going to happen here. So it's going to basically, in the other systems, it's going to basically be less churned here, most churned here. Now, we know that. So gold is going to have the chance, the hardest gold to catch, the most difficult gold to catch in this box, the flightiest gold that gold that's going to get away is going to get captured down here. Not up here. Now we know with DreamHat we're doing a really good job. Like I said, front row gold, but pay attention. The hardest gold, the most difficult gold, the impossible gold, the unicorn gold, the gold you just can't catch, you're going to have the most chance of catching it down here because it has been turned, exchanged, gone through the process, floating, having a chance to liberate and fall out here because this is where the most exchanges happen. The gold has went through its most chaos here. So we're going to see the hardest gold caught here. So with that said, let's land the plane. This mat has the best recovery. The best recovery in this system. That's why it's at the end. To catch that gold that would get away. Now we understand that easy, dumb gold, harder gold, hardest gold. Easy, dumb. Harder, hardest. Easy, dumb. Harder, hardest. So that's what we're doing here. And the reason I'm doing it this way, and a lot of people say, because they have a lot of teaching, because they want to have that mat that catches the most, because those other patterns, if you let the gold get moving, this is just a ramp, Evel Knievel's out, gets too much inertia going, doesn't work. Here's the deal. It's like trying to catch the fine gold in the nugget catch. That's what you're trying to do. People are trying to catch the fine gold in the nugget catch, the big with the big super duper whale waves, whale tails, all the exaggerations, all the craziness, the super crazy mat. So they're trying to catch with the gold that hasn't settled out yet. Because we're mostly talking about high bakers here, but sluices also hasn't settled out yet in the craziness. But we know you can't catch boulders, flower amongst boulders. We can't catch the fine gold if it hasn't had a chance to settle out. So that's why we come over this smooth mat and catch all the pixie dust and let it level out and settle out nice. Catch all the pixie dust nice, sweet little knot. Don't shake it up. Kind of catch all the pixie dust. We know the big gold's going to roll off. We know the big material's going to roll off. All that stuff. Nice. You guys feel that? How nice that is? I'm teasing people, but I'm just letting you know. All that nice gold that needs that lower flow, lower churning, and needs to kind of sneak in there, gets caught in here. So it allows us to get some really sneaky gold by outsmarting it up front here. And then as we go through this, we're picking up fine gold because we're going to hide it in the black sands that this didn't catch. And even though this does super good job, so we're going to have great recovery here, greater, most bestest. So anyways, the one thing that we've learned too is that this cleans better. And if you're cleaning gold, you're losing gold. You cannot make this all gold, no cons, and expect not one flake of gold out of all that cleaning to fall out like a Miller table. Or any kind of table or any kind of situation where you're cleaning the gold, you have sacrificial gold that rolls off. So we know that has less cons, even though it does a really good job capturing the fine gold. We know we're going to see gold shedding off of this. We know here we gather more cons. We gather black sands, heavy sands, material in here, giving a place for this gold, for whatever reason, didn't want to sit in here to collect in these cells. And then we do it again with more cons. And so the even flightier gold that's hardest to catch, we're putting it in these bigger cells with more cons, hiding it, capturing that gold, not letting it slip away, grabbing our nuggets that are trying to roll, all that kind of stuff. So on top of all this, let me grab one more thing, jump out of the camera here, but you can still hear me. It's okay. I'm coming back. It's okay. Let's talk about a system of thinking now. Now we got this, the Jarvin Ripple. All right, me and Paul developed this. I had this great idea. I didn't have time to build it. Said, Paul, build it, test it, tell me what you think. And Paul said, gotta have it, gotta make it, gotta love it. What we're doing here, in the beginning of our sluice box, is we understand in this box or even in this box, doesn't matter, If we can slow gold down before it gets to the mat, we win. Slow gold down before it gets to the mat, we win. So in Friday, crash box, nugget catch, specimens won't roll out. So the idea was we are creating a baffle. Miner's moss goes underneath this. This clamps over your dream mat here. And as the material goes through, the finer stuff goes through, baffles out, slows its velocity down, and then the bigger light stuff gets raked off because we don't want it. We want it to go away. So we're concentrating, slowing down our spine goal, slowing down our goal before it reaches the mat. So we're bringing it in before it reaches the mat. And then as it leaches out, it's at a slower velocity. It isn't riding up in the waves. It isn't a kite blown in the wind. And it leaches out onto the mat and gets caught in the cells. This Jarvin Ripple in front of every crash box is going to be a revolution. We are going to see all the other manufacturers copy this. They will copy this. You watch. Time tells all. This in the dredge box, this in a high banker, is the coup ferré. If anybody knows what I'm talking about there, I've ever played that game. This is the one. You know, like in that game, you had four coup ferrés. You had puncher-proof, speed limit, ambulance, and right-of-way, I think, or something. Driving ace. This is like all four together. This guy here is going to make it happen. I know I lost all you guys on that illustration, but go get the game Miles Born. Have some fun with your kids. It's awesome. All right, so that guy there in a high banker and in a dredge, especially a flare dredge, is just like kissing babies. It is so awesome. Kissing puppies, whatever it is you're into kissing. That there is awesome. It sucks that metal prices, especially perforated metal prices, has gone through the roof. And the material is like gold out there. It sucks because of our wonderful leader who doesn't know how to run the economy. Never mind. So anyways, we got these mats. I hope I kind of illustrated what's going on. I wasn't trying to be too tense in this, but I just got a lot of stuff going on. I just wanted to like really get into this. I just really wanted to make a statement. I didn't want to be passive about it. I wanted to be assertive about it. I wanted to be confident about it because we understand that as the material rolls across this, we're going to get all that pixie dust out. And then we're going to start grabbing more of the pixie dust because we have more cons for the really flighty stuff to land into. And then we got even more cons for the even flightier stuff because fine gold has to hide amongst the black sands. Now, it can't hide amongst a big slick of material that builds up over the top of the miner's moss like a sandbar that isn't active and it just rides over the top. We got to have active exchange. We got to be able to bring it in, spin it in like a runaway truck. Runaway truck's going down the hill. It's a kite. You can't stop it. It ain't just going to roll on the sand and get caught. It is like a truck that goes into a runaway ramp and it sinks in the sand, but a circular one where you sink that those flakes into the sand. And the ones that get away, we're going to jump out and go here. Now, this is the Dustin's illustration. Dustin McMurray gave me this illustration once, and I just kissed him for it. So, Dave, flake of gold comes in the dream mat. If it goes in here, does a couple spins, pops out, Just say it does that all the way down, and then gets caught down to here. Now, take that path of that flake of gold that did all that. Get caught here, straighten out that string, your sluice box is like 14 feet long. The other systems, because they have just straight lines this way, perpendicular to the flow, they just roll out like pencils. They're just gone. Your sluice box actually is only 3 foot. No matter how many ramps you have in it, it tumbles, goes up the air ramp, tumbles. You see what's going on? You're rolling the marble. Retrace the path of that flake of gold in the other boxes, and it is a lot shorter. So Dream Mat has the ability to make itself look longer. So in all the combinations. So we want the mini, we want this up front. And here's the closing of all this. This right here is the perfect indicator mat. And high recovery. It's not the main recovery, but it's good recovery. It's really main recovery if you go use it for a cleanup mat and go really slow, but as you're sluicing. So you see the gold start to stick in here. And it's like an indicator mat, lets you know if you're on the gold. And one of the things that's nice about this, most of all your fine gold, if you're sluicing or high banking at the right speed and you're getting good exchange, it's going to get caught all in this mat right here. Most of it is. I would say over 80% of your fine gold will be in here. So what does that do when you're getting ready to do a cleanup? You pull that mat out, and then you basically, however you want to do it, you know, you can swish that baby into your pan, and you can pan out most of all your gold without having to deal with all these cons right away. And see your gold, get a tablespoon of con, suck out your gold, be good to go. This mat right here, I do not understand why people aren't buying the cube version of this, cutting it up, putting it on top of their sluice boxes for like they do with the V-rib. This makes V-rib look like a prehistoric square wheel. It is so much more efficient than that. In any case, in any situation, it just spanks the V-rib. And even in the little cleanup sluices, migration rolling, you ever notice that? We all been there. There hasn't been a person out there that hasn't seen the V-rib and sees the little flake of gold, rushes to get his bottle, goes back, it's gone. Oh, it's down there a couple more. Oh, nope. Goes to move. Oh, it's in the mat now. Because that's how much migration happens. It stops it for a time. And some chunks do get caught because we got chaos and it happens just the right size, wedges in there, that's good. But most of the gold migrates across, but it lets you see it there for a second. What we see here is the gold stops in the cell and it stays there and you're sluicing the whole time, all day. And that flake of gold stays there. And we see that over and over again, lots of videos. Anybody wants to see a really good YouTube subscriber that's out there, Northern Pickers, has in Scotland, has a YouTube channel and he's using these mats. And you should see his cleanups and his gold recovery. Man, thumbs up to that guy. All right, guys, that's enough of that time. I hope I answered your questions. Hope I make you feel more confident about our gold recovery dream mat. Help you understand that this next level recovery breaks a lot of the rules, breaks a lot of the norms, breaks a lot of the stigmas, breaks a lot of the traditions, breaks a lot of the superstitions. Because we are focusing on science, facts, and recovery, and we care nothing about the shape of the mat, we care about the recovery. And that's why this mat looks so different than the other mat, because the mat's shape is totally engineered around results. It has nothing to do with how it looks, or I think it looks cool, or somebody else thinks it looks cool. Its shape was designed and focused around better recovery. All right, guys, there's the dream mat spiel for you. Hope you're having a good Saturday. I'm going to go relax this evening, have dinner with the wife and brother and his wife. Have a good time. All right. Dream Mat, guys. What's in your box?